All right, hello. Today, we're gonna see the best primer in the game. This is a thing that I've been using on my epic disruption weapons videos in the series over there. So I'm gonna show this once and for all because a lot of people have been asking for the build and I think a video would be great to showcase the capabilities and why it is the best. So, when we're talking about the primer weapon, a primer weapon is a weapon that spreads a lot of status effects onto enemies so you can then kill them really fast with your weapon of choice. This is very important because on weapons that are being primed, you get galvanized aptitudes and galvanized shots. This mod gives the quote-unquote gun CO that we're talking about, that is either multiplicative or additive. There is a list I'm gonna add to the description that shows pretty much every gun in the game which is multiplicative and which is additive. Every gun that is a hitscan is additive, so it's not added to that list, and every other gun is added to that list and explained if it's multiplicative, if it's additive, and if it has some weird mechanics behind it. So that's basically what gun CO is. It's the damage that you get from this mod over here and the galvanized shot mod for secondary weapons. And primary weapons are weapons that buff the mods over there with a lot of status effects. And the compressor, as a secondary weapon, is by far the best primer in the game. And this is because the compressor is a fully automatic secondary pistol that shoots bubbles that then explode and deal viral damage with 30% status chance. So with a build like this, where you can go radiation, viral, corrosive, and cold, by modding for corrosive cold and accelerated isotope, you understand that you can get some pretty insane status effects on the enemy on its own, and then you add secondary cucumber, which is a secondary only arcane that it boosts status effects even further and gives you more random status effects. You can get some really nasty status strokes onto the enemy, and one mag is really enough to do this, especially with a base multi-shot of 4, because this is a shotgun pistol, essentially. So the compressor, by far one of the most useful secondaries in the game, and easily the best primer in the game, and we're gonna see it in action. So how are we gonna see it in action? I have the Comrex here, a gun that I really, really like. It will be on the list of the epic disruption weapons video. That's a spoiler. But this gun has a multiplicative galvanized CO. So to showcase how OP this is, we're gonna have this build that only has gun CO, point strike, and vital sense with primary deadhead. And then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna use the compressor, a glaive prime, to just take the keys from enemies, and we're gonna do a disruption mission with Zara's Whisper in this mechanic. And you're gonna see that even with three mods, the Comrex will be enough to kill the demo units really, really quickly. So we're gonna go to Olympus to showcase this on Steelpath, obviously. And this is, like, by far the best weapon to do this with, but there are other weapons you can do it and get pretty good value, like the Epitaph is the most popular one by far, the Nucor is another very popular one. Generally, the weapons are pretty good, pretty good. I think the Epitaph is the best one because it's super easy to use. You just shoot anywhere and you get a guaranteed cold proc, you get a lot of things going on. But the compressor is by far the best at doing this job. So, at the start, we're gonna just get some kills with the glaive prime to spawn keys. Swear to God, a lot of people are gonna ask for the glaive prime build after the video. But, I mean, it's glaive prime. Even just adding prime pressure point, you can unironically kill Steelpath with this weapon. So there's our key. So we're gonna use it. We're now gonna prime some enemies. Oh, never mind. Can you not kill them, please? Alright. I want my deadhead stack. Alright. Two deadhead stacks should be enough. So we're gonna proc Zada's Whisper. Actually, I shouldn't have proc'd it, but it's fine. Do this. Strip him off his armor. And two shots are enough to kill him. Two shots are enough to kill him. And this is a Comorix with just that. I'm not using anything crazy here. I'm using galvanized aptitude, point strike, and, you know, vital sense. That's all I'm using. That is all we need. Yeah. We're gonna just complete the mission so I can showcase this in action. And people may say, okay, Comorix is broken. Well, it is good. Yes, it will be one of the weapons, but I think this is the best showcase for me to do this over here. So, once again, we're gonna go and proc our good old deadhead sacks. Okay. Amazing. Go back. I'm gonna do it correctly. I'm gonna prime first. So prime him. Strip his armor. Zada's Whisper, and took a bit more shots because I think one bullet missed, but still, for three mods, that is very, very nice. So as you see, on its own, doesn't do much. 168k damage with priming, so makes a huge difference. Two shots even with armor on the heavy gunner. It is really, really strong. Like, it really is, but yeah. You would think this weapon is fully modded if I showed you it one-shots steel path, but it actually isn't. This is just compressor buffing it to fuck. So, the other whispers run out, so this is without it, even, but this guy is kind of squishy, so not the worst thing in the world, still. Pretty good. I'm not sure why my weapon unzooms. That is kind of weird, but eh. Not a deal breaker, in my opinion. I'm gonna try to get Zada's back. Actually, I'll just do that. Just showcase it one last time. So, I'll get this guy. So that is kind of weird with a bubble sometimes when it comes to using it after a primer. You can get a bubble on a very weird spot and then it doesn't do damage and then it suddenly one-shots. But you get the idea of what priming in this game is and the idea... Hello there. Yeah, you get the idea of what priming in this game is, and you also get the idea of how strong it can be in combination with a weapon that has multiplicative CO. Because you can imagine, if a Comorix can do this, what would a Stalter do that has multiplicative CO on a secondary fire with 200% crit chance, 10,000 damage, and 13 times multiplier? Like, you understand where I'm going here. This is why I vouch for the Stalter being a super, super strong gun. And this is why I can hit the level cap numbers with the Stalter and even higher than level cap. Double the level cap, in fact. So, yeah. That is basically it. I'm gonna show you once again. The build I was using is Point Strike, Vital Sense, Galvanized Aptitude, and Dead Hit. We are missing 5 mods here. We're using no multi-shot, no base damage, no elemental damage at all, no Bane mod, nothing. Literally nothing. We're just using base crits and aptitude. That's it. And it is enough to one-shot steel path enemies. Because compressor exists, and priming in this game is a mechanic. So yeah, very good. If you're like, okay, but I mean, how do you get compressor? Well, You get it from the vent kits. But if I'm gonna be honest, just buy it for plat. I mean, just buy it for plat. What was it, 120? It's fucking worth it. Like, it's not worth going through the vent kits. Just buy it. Just buy it with plat. That's what I did. I am rank 0 on the vent kits. What I did is I farmed Wisp Prime sets, and I sold like 20 of them. And then I just bought it. That's all I did. Yeah. If you don't have compressor, Epitaph is fine. Nuker with magnetic progenitor is also fine. Twin Colmac is really good with the Arcane. Then, what else? Twin Gracatas are really good. There are guns that are pretty good with it, but it's just nothing comes even close to how good the compressor is. It's insane. But yeah. That is the video. That is what I wanted to showcase. And that is why you can clearly understand on your own that every gun is pretty much level cap viable using a strategy like this. So, once again, I thank you very much for watching this video. And I'll leave Discord Twitch links on the description as always. And I'll see you in the next one.